Hey, what's up, guys? Angelo here with a tutorial on how to edit an aviation photo using Lightroom and the Nik software suite. I had a friend that was having some issues with the image that he was uploading, and he was basically getting a lot of noise, and he was asking me, how do I get rid of the noise in the sky and in the shadowed areas? So I want to just take you through a quick tutorial. It's similar to the stuff I've been doing before, but there might be a few twists that I'll add to it as I go along the way. So as you can see, just looking at the histogram here, I guess it's exposed okay. I'm not exactly sure why at just 60 millimeters he was shooting so such a narrow depth of field. I think I would have been at least f8 because he's got plenty of shutter speed at a low ISO. So think about that when you're out there shooting. On a bright day like this, there's no reason to be shooting down at 5.6 unless you're really shooting for a narrow depth of field. So that being said, let's move on and do the basic stuff that I do with all of my photos. I go to the Develop module in Lightroom, and I start at the top. I'm pleased with the white balance as it looks right here. I always pull the highlights down a little bit. I always open my shadows up a little bit. The whites, you can see, I've got these checkboxes checked here and here. It's going to show me if I have any blown out areas. You can see they get red when they're blown out. So I pull those back, make sure I don't have any of those areas. And blacks, it's the same thing. You can slide to the left. You can see everything that's going to be underexposed. Slide to the right till the blue pixels are gone. You should be just fine. I'm not adding clarity. I'm not adding vibrance, not saturation, nothing here. It's going to be just a very basic edit. Okay, as far as sharpening is concerned, Lightroom defaults into this zoomed in view, which is nice. Looks like you got a nice sharp image. I mean, the windows are very well defined. So I'm real pleased with that. What I'll do is I hold Option down on my keypad. I'm on a MacBook Pro. I'll slide to the right to about 40, and then I'll bring the radius down to 5.5. And then I will mask the sharpening. And this is also an opportunity to see what spots we've got. You can definitely see that we've got some issues. We've got a couple spots up there. So the first thing I'll do is I'll hit my healing brush. Then I'll turn on visualize spots. Sometimes it shows them. Sometimes if they're too faint, they won't. But in this case, it looks good. So we'll hit this one. We'll hit this one. I'll increase the diameter of the brush and hit that one. And we should be good. Back to the sharpening dialog box, continuing with holding Option on my keypad, sliding to the right. I'm going to mask off anything that's dark, does not get the sharpening. We just want the edges sharpened, so that looks good. I'm not going to do any noise reduction in Lightroom. I do that later. And then we're going to go ahead and enable profile corrections, remove aberration, make sure that this tab is checked, and we're going to level the shot. I'll let Lightroom see if it can level it. It looks like it did a fairly good job. It's probably going off this post in the middle, which is exactly what I would do. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to think about the crop here. I'm going to pull it in equidistant to the nose of the airplane just because it looks more uniform. It looks better. And see if maybe a 16:9 might work here. I kind of like that. We're still getting the control tower in, and we're putting the airplane on the bottom third, which to me, it looks nice. So we're going to, now I can obviously see down here as this crop shows, I'm going to have to clone out these posts. I don't like those down here. So we'll do that later in Lightroom. So at this point, we're going to control click, edit in Photoshop, and we'll be right back. We're going to go to Nik Define, and we're going to go ahead and let it do its automatic searching of noise. And I can look in the dialog box in the bottom right and see that it is finding some noise in the sky and it is getting rid of it. I'll look down here in the shadow of the airplane. There might be a little, and it's getting rid of that too. So let's accept that and move to the next phase, which is going to be Color Effects Pro. Okay, we're going to go Filter, Nik, Color Effects Pro. Now, Color Effects Pro, when it opens, as you know, it'll open with whatever filter you were last using, and in my case, I use a lot of this bleach bypass. One thing that you have to understand is how control point technology works, okay? These control points are cool, but if Right now, this filter is being applied to the entire image. I do not want to put anything in this sky. This is a very muted, gray, hazy sky. If I start putting a whole bunch of contrast and detail like I like, you're going to generate noise in that sky that you're going to have to go back and undo. So because we don't have any cool clouds back there, I want to eliminate the effect from that area. And I want to focus the effect where I want it. I don't want to put highlights, and I don't want to put this muted area under any duress by adding filters to it. So we're going to selectively get rid of those areas, and we're going to use the control point technology to do it. So this is about what I like to do for my bleach bypass settings. Sometimes I'll go up a little bit on the contrast. Just depends. Put the negative control point in the sky. Increase the diameter. Okay? And now what I'm going to do is put the positive control point down here. Okay? Increase the diameter. I got 2 points. Now I'm going to zoom. I'm going to look at the mask by opening my control point tab up and clicking this button. Now I can see exactly where the filter is. If it's jet black, it's masked. It's not there. If it's pure white, all of the effect is there. So I sort of like this. We got a little bit of the effect going on, maybe 50% here. I don't want the white of the airplane having that, but the red tail can have it. You can see that this isn't totally black, so all I'm going to do is hold Option on my keypad, grab that spot, and drag it up again. I've duplicated that, and I've told it to look for some more pixels in the sky. Okay? I might even do it one more time over here. Now I'm fairly certain the sky is masked out. But you can see that it sort of made the tower a little bit more masked. So I'll grab this one and I'll drag it up. As you can see there, I'm putting, I'm moving around a little bit. Looks like, there we go. That's a good spot. So we've got some of the effect here, lots of the effect here, none of the effect here. I like that. Hit this tab again. You can kind of see what you got going on, and it looks good. So now I'm going to add my next filter. And I'm going to show you just basically what is a cool look for me. Your mileage may vary. Do what you want. I like to add a little brilliance and warmth to my shots. I start with a little perceptual saturation, not a ton, 5 to 10. And I'll add just a little bit of warmth if it's a warm, sunny day. If it's a cool night, I don't do this. All right, so that looks cool. And I just let that hit the whole of the photo. Adding another one. Now we're going to go to your choice. You could go detail extractor. And my friend used detail extractor, so I'm going to. I sort of like to go pro contrast here, and I'll show you the difference, but let's go ahead with some detail. Here's your detail extractor. So you got to be careful with this particular filter. This is a powerful filter. This is sort of like Clarity in Lightroom. You can get way out of control with this, and it can look really whacked, okay? So it opens at 25, 6, 6, and normal. I usually don't use 25. I'll back this down to maybe 15 or 20. Okay, that's close enough. I'll add a little more contrast because I don't want to brighten the photo too much on the highlights. And I like to change my effect radius to fine. All right, it's more subtle that way. I'll slide this slider over so that I'm protecting my highlights. I'm not applying it to the highlighted area. And then I will, again, use my control point technology. So I'm going to put a negative control point in the sky, increase the diameter, just like before, put a positive control point down here, increase the diameter. Okay? And then open up this tab and have a look and see what we're getting. I might slide this, holding Option, I'll slide this down to make sure I get the sky. Okay, that looks good. And I will put a, well, I didn't need to do that. I could just drag this other control point, like I showed you earlier, up a little bit. Just so that we can get a little bit more of the airplane. And I'm going to do another holding option just to make sure I got that sky. I don't want any detail in that sky. There's nothing up there to put detail on. So why do that, right? Okay, guys. So I like what I've got here. Okay, moving on down. We'll close this and go to our next filter. So we've got bleach, we've got brilliance, we've got detail. I like to finish this off with pro contrast, okay? And just kind of like the look that it gives the photo. It really makes it pop, okay? So what I'll do is I'll usually go about maybe 10 or 15 on both correct and dynamic. Then I'm going to go ahead, and again, I do not want that in the sky. You're going to generate noise up here if you do. So putting our control points here, just like before. And if you didn't have a grassy area here, just put your first control point in a shadowed area on the airplane, not the highlighted area. Let's have a look and see what we've got. Okay, I'm going to hold option down on my keyboard, drag that up there to make sure I've got okay, and then hold option here and head off. You're right about there, looks good. All right, that looks nice. Okay, we'll close that dialog box now. And overall, it's looking pretty nice. You know, if you've got a lot of grass down here, you could always try the foliage. That's kind of cool. That can add a little bit of color down here to, you can see if I turn the effect off and on, what we got, that's off and that's on. I like that. Adds a little bit more color to the foreground. And then because we cropped so tight, I don't bother with dark and light and center because I don't want to put a vignette here. It's going to clip off the tail and the nose. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and accept this, send it back into Photoshop now. That's the before and that's the after. Before and after. It looks really nice. Now, at this point, let's say you had some issues with something up here that looked like noise. You can always do a mask, right? Add a mask, Command I to invert the mask, and then grab a brush that's white and just paint it in, right? Avoiding this area. That's one way if the control point technology didn't get exactly what you were looking for, okay? But in our case, it did. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this mask because I'm happy with the product thus far. Okay, let's clean up those posts. I don't like them, okay? So I'm just going to grab my healing brush tool. It is, and by the way, hit B for brush to begin with. Go up here and make sure you've got a soft brush selected. Then go to the healing brush tool. All right. And then just get rid of these things. And you can see it does a really good job. I mean, it really, it's simple. Okay. All in all, she's looking good. So now we're going to sharpen. Now, oh my gosh, there are so many ways to sharpen your images, okay? I have done it all. Alpha sharpening, lab color sharpening, you know, unsharp mask, over, high pass sharpening. And I just bought a new, I paid $110 US to buy Picture, which is a Mac product. I gotta tell you, I'm pretty excited to have it. It's like one step, boom, done. Very easy, but I'm not going to do that now. What I'm going to do is show you a basic high-pass sharpening that works really nice, okay? Now, my thought process is I want to keep one full-size photo and put one on the web, okay? So I duplicate the background, and I then duplicate the image, okay? On the duplicated image, that's the one I'm going to put on the web. I'm working on that one first. I'm now going to resize it right here. okay? And we'll take this one down to 1400 pixels. I just use bicubic automatic unless it's a night shot. Then I use bicubic best for smooth gradients. You can see I've got these three boxes checked, hit OK. Now we've got a resized photo, so I'm going to zoom back into 100% so I can see exactly what I'm working with. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to change our blend mode to overlay. Okay? The next thing we're going to do is we're going to go filter, other, high pass. Now, what we're looking for is just the beginning of the bordered contrasty edges. You can see how much is too much. Too much is when you start to see a significantly defined edge area. We don't want that. So this, because it's the reduced size, is going to take a lot less. Here's point one. We can't see anything, right? Here's 2.5. Starting to see it. Let's take a look at the front of the plane. Actually like that. 0.5 is the number. So hit OK, right? And then now what we're going to do is change the blend mode to soft light. Now, what have we done? We've added some subtle sharpening to the image. If it's not enough, we can go to hard light. That's a little bit more of a pop on the sharpening, okay? But what I always do here is I mask this, Command I and invert it, grab B for a brush, and I grab the hard brush in this case, and I sharpen just the airplane, making sure that you have a white brush down here, the airplane in the foreground. So I want to go ahead and put my sharpening here. I don't want it in the sky because I'm going to put noise in the sky if I do that. If I had clouds up there, I would. Adjust my, you don't have to be super particular with this, just close, okay? Okay, and that looks pretty good. So at this point, we can go File, Save for Web. All right, and this gives you a good look. It looks fantastic. I mean, it's sharp, it's not blurred, it don't have edge halos. If we did, we could clean those up, but we don't have that problem because we didn't go too far on the edges. Actually on the radius when I put the high pass on there. So now we're gonna save this to the desktop, all right? And then we can get rid of it unless you wanted a watermarked version. So let's get rid of it. Don't make the mistake and save this. Get rid of it. Now we're back to the full size one, same thing. We're gonna change the blend mode to overlay, okay? Then we're gonna go filter, other, high pass. Now, because this is the full size version, we're gonna need more radius, okay? So let's get up to the airplane. You could do what I just did, or you could just come right here. And now how much is too much? All right. See this white edge? That's too much. Back it down, back it down. All right, I'm liking that. I think that's good. So let's hit OK, and then let's change it to soft light. Let's zoom in and see what we got. So now let's put a mask, let's invert the mask, grab your brush, it's a hard brush. I'll just zoom out to make this quick and easy. Increase the diameter, and let's paint it in. Okay. All right. So let's zoom back in and take a look. There's 100%. Let's turn the sharpening off, on, off and on. All in all, that looks looks pretty good to me. I mean, there's no noise, no pixelation. There's no problems with this image as it is. I like everything about it. So there you have it. I hope this tutorial helps. Expect a few more. I've got a couple other friends of mine that wanted some help, and I'm going to walk them through a tutorial as well. I hope you guys have a great day.